got our buddy, stock watcher, stock market analyst extraordinaire, Scott Martin on the phone. Says, all right, Scott, the second member of the Trillion Dollar Club, not on a closing basis. We've hit it. Amazon's pulled back a little bit. Not unusual to see that sort of selling the news kind of thing, but it's pretty clear this is a juggernaut that does not look like it's going to stop.
It doesn't at all, Charles, and you pointed out all morning that this is a company that has really, let's say, improved its stripes. You know, you talked about the marketing part that, you know, is coming onto the company now, where the massive margin that they're seeing in the advertising side of things. You know, Amazon Prime, don't forget, you know, they raised the price on Amazon Prime a few months ago by $20 and found a couple additional $1 billion in revenue just from that. And Amazon Prime, to me, remains the gateway drug to massive internet spending because it's one of the best deals on the planet still for those who use it. And so it just goes to show you that Amazon is one of these companies, Charles, that can just adapt to the current environment so well and create so much margin ability to just completely increase what they're doing on their bottom line that I don't think this stock will be stopped. You know, we saw some price targets recently pop up to 2,500 and therefore higher too. So I think this is a stock that still, even though it is up so much this year, if you have some cash on the sidelines, you got to jump in.
And so you don't care about share price, right? I mean, if you could buy one share, buy one share. Just be a part owner of this thing, Scott?
Yeah, and you know, the interesting thing, Charles, it kind of adds a little bit of exclusivity to the name too, and it does, I think, please some of those institutional investors that are looking at these high-priced stocks. That does discourage, too, maybe a little bit of day trading, too, don't forget, because the high price, when you're trading a high-priced stock, tends to discourage as much day trading as it does with some of these other lower-priced stocks, where the volatility then will get sucked out of the name a little bit in Amazon's case. So that's not a bad deal either. Plus the fact, too, that I think Amazon, you know, when you look at the valuation, that's really what we should be looking at, not just the stock price. And the fact that it joins another great name in Apple, which we own as well, Amazon and Apple, that's another reason that I think, you know, that's why we should be heralding this name, not just the $2,000 price.
Scott Martin, thanks for hopping on the phone with us. We always appreciate it.
You got it.
All right.